What is it?
There's a secret button.
On the pedestal?
I'm gonna push it.
I don't think that's a good idea.
Pushing it!
Holy crap! I've gotta get this on film!
I don't even know what to think of this. It's all written in code. Why would Enigma keep this a secret from me?
Dang it, the last recording is gone. So's our friend, Kekri. Guess he didn't like hanging out with us.
You're always too quick to assume when someone doesn't like you. Maybe he didn't want to be filmed for some reason? He could have made a lot of enemies with his line of work. And he did say he had a hotel to get to.
But wouldn't he tell us at least?
And that's my exact thought about this. Why not tell me?
Can you make anything of it?
All I can say is that it doesn't look good.
Looks like it's starting to get late. Maybe we should head home.
I still can't get over what Enigma's plans are supposed to mean. That's gonna be bugging me all night. Oh well. I guess we should.
Stringer! Duck!
What's a duck? Oh, hi, Petrum!
Oh, hey, Stryker. Didn't see you there.
Moving buildings?
Actually demolishing this one. Who's your friend?
This is Cam. It's her first time in Angelica.
Well then, welcome to the capital of Astoria.
Thanks.
Cam, this is Petrum. He can fully route rocks and work with construction and destruction crews.
And odd rock floaty jobs in between.
Nice to meet you. So how did you guys meet?
Oh, I know pretty much every dragon that was raised in the Orphan Temple. My parents runs the place.
You have connections, that's for sure. Speaking of which, that's where we met Enigma, isn't it?
Met? You know full well we all spent 100 years together in that place. Me, her, you, your sister, and a whole bunch of other orphans.
Don't remind me.
What?
Nothing. I just wanted to bring up Enigma.
Why?
Well, forgive me for eavesdropping, but I heard you were talking about her. She hired me to help her with a thing a while ago.
Do you know what she's up to?
She paid me very well to keep it a secret, but I told her I didn't want to know what was going on anyway. The whole business is shady if you ask me. Don't even know where she's getting the money from.
Aw, probably Ryan. They have this deal where she transport him through realms quickly and gets a share of the profits.
Ugh, figures. Those shifty types being mixed up and all.
Don't talk about my friend that way! I'm sure she has a good reason for keeping, whatever this is a secret.
Or a very bad one.
For the record, I think we all mix up with Ryan one way or another. Do you know anything about this or not?
Long story short, no. And I would say don't try to find out, but I know you will, so just please be careful, alright?
When am I ever not?
Who's Ryan?
Another old friend? Hey, Petrum, is he in town?
Well, rumor has it he snuck in with the circus.
Excellent! Do you have time for one more stop?
So, do we know where this guy is?
Nope.
Do we know what he looks like?
Maybe.
What he sounds like?
He's been all over. He probably picked up some dumb acid.
Is there anything that we're going off of here?
He can control water, runs a store, and is a butthead.
Why do you want to find him again?
To ask him about Enigma, and maybe yell at him a little. Say, have you ever been to one of these carnival thingies in either?
No. Why?
Just wondering. Try not to freak out. None of these tents are looking right. He will probably be more hidden.
Why would his tent be-
Come on!
Maybe we should ask someone?
Oh look! Clowns! Let's go talk to them!
Let's not!
I don't think he is in here.
Well, then how do we get out? What are we doing again?
Ryan.
Right. What if he doesn't want to be found?
We've almost searched this entire place. If he's going to show up, he'll do it soon.
You know what? I bet we'll find him in the cotton candy machine.
You just read my mind! Well?
Well what?
I'm freeing all these poor animals.
Some of them are spirits.
Well, they don't deserve to be sold off and caged up like...
animals?
Some of them are spirits.
Uh-huh. Have fun with that.
Don't even try to stop me. I'll call the Animal Protection Services.
Why?
Because this is cruel.
Sure.
And inhuman.
Obviously. Did you think I was a human?
And probably illegal.
That's cute. What's your name?
Sage.
Sage. Everything you see before you is probably illegal. From all these cages, to that pile of terror junk foods, to the wall of precarious playthings. Nobody's caught me now, and nobody ever will.
Well, I'm calling them anyway.
I like your style. How long is this breakout gonna take again?
Come on, you can go now. Ow!
Have you ever wondered why none of these cages have locks on them? It's because they don't need them. All these poor little creatures stay in voluntarily, as hard as it may be for you to believe. They know where their food comes from, so that's where they stay. Now, if you were to buy one...
What about that cage? That one has a lock on it.
Well, that's an exception.
That does it! I'm turning it in myself.
Aw, come on. Don't run the hardwood while you're at it.
You liar! You psychopath!
Businessman.
What's wrong, Ryan? Getting rid of annoying customers always puts you in a good mood.
It's just the deadline's getting closer, and we don't have nearly enough crystals.
Plus, you miss your girlfriend.
Oh, zip it. We just team up sometimes. She's probably not even interested in me.
But you're interested in her.
Okay, I'm just done with you for today.
No! I'm so dizzy!
So, this is what you do when you're alone.
Well, if it isn't Little Striker all grown up. How much of that did you hear?
Something about a girlfriend?
I was just joking around. Having such a useless power can keep me entertained at least.
You just flung a dragon out of sight! I wouldn't call that useless!
Yeah, but I can only control water, not make my own. Not unless I eat a crystal or something. So I have to bring it all from Terra.
Looks like that's not the only thing you bring from there.
What is it that you do, exactly?
He steals things from Terra, and rips dragons off for them here.
Hey now, just because you can't exactly pay for something human-made without freaking them out, doesn't mean it's stolen from them. Why does everyone always assume it's stolen?
is it?
That's not the point. I mean, where's the trust?
Trust? You're this most infamous comham!
Little old me, stop it, I'm blushing.
And ancients know what else you've been up to!
Such as?
Weapons, creatures, drug rings, assassin rings!
Assassins? Everyone knows those are just an urban legends. And besides, you don't want to talk about bringing things from Terra.
What?
Your friend. She comes from there, right?
How did you...
The way you stand gives it away. I prefer walking on my feet myself. It makes me feel tall. We can be bipedal buddies.
Oh, okay.
I'm also guessing you didn't choose to grow up there as much as you chose to let Stryker bring you here. Be careful where you let her bring you. She thinks I'm a bad influence or something, but the crazy adventures she drags other dragons on can be downright hazardous to their health.
I have very big ears.
Tell me, what's the weirdest thing you've had to adjust to here?
Oh, well, maybe that nobody has a gender?
We're ethereal beings, so we don't really need them to function or to reproduce.
But everyone's called he or she.
There's a word for that in chirpy language, but in English terms we just judge it by the pitch of your voice so it's less confusing.
And that we're... like... phoenixes?
Ah yes, reincarnation. When a dragon turns 100, they gain the ability to be reborn.
She knows all this.
Hush. They disappear in a flash, and during those seconds, they can choose whether or not to keep their memories. If they choose to keep them, they can also choose to alter the colors and patterns on their fur.
But wouldn't that get super confusing if everyone was always changing?
Do humans stop recognizing their friends if they change clothes? It's the same way with this. They still have the same face, same voice, same powers. Now, if a dragon chooses not to keep their memories, well, no one knows what happens after that. But all that's left behind is an egg which will hatch into a completely different baby dragon. Dragons who do this are usually tired of life, are in trouble, and want an easy way out. They can designate someone they trust to take care of them, but more often than not, they have nobody. This leads to a lot of unclaimed eggs lying around, especially in big cities where they're stolen by Abyssians and trained as soldiers, or so they tell us. Luckily, we have egg hunters on the lookout to scoot them off the streets, and into the orphanage they go. But they can't always find them all. Looks like you are the one that got away.
Not exactly.
Don't worry. You weren't missing much in that dump.
Seriously, what's your problem with me?
Nothing personal. I pretty much act this petty with everyone I used to know. In fact, I'm glad you finally paid me a visit. I know you don't approve of my business, or my involvement with your bestie, which leads me to believe that you didn't come here just because you missed me. You must want something pretty darn bad, so let's hear it. Unless I hear with a message from your parents.
Would it hurt you just to visit them?
Yes, actually. Have you seen your old lady with a rolling pin? But I'm getting sidetracked here. What is it that you want?
Information! On this!
Ooh, that's gonna cost you!
But...
You didn't expect to get anything free here, did you?
Well, I got money.
Well, so do I. But I want something specific for a secret like this.
Do you even know what this is?
Don't worry, I know this is Enigma's. I know what she's building, and I know what she plans to do with it. But I want something in return. A wear badge of the Crystal Guard variety. It's a rare collector's item.
You probably just want it so you can sneak into places. How are we supposed to get that?
Not my problem. What? God, I should really move that into the back room.
Please tell me it's not what I think it is.
Okay, it's not what you think it is.
Hey!
Put us down!
Talk to me when you have the badge. Bye!
Well, that was excruciating.
Yeah, he's kind of a jerk.
Well, he must have some way to be charming, or else he wouldn't sell a thing. Cam?
Hmm?
Am I really that bad?
Well, you can be reckless at times, but nobody's perfect. You were the first dragon to welcome me to the Aether. You made this strange place feel like home to me, and if it weren't for you, I'd probably never step outside my comfort zone, so... No.
That was... the nicest thing I've ever heard. Come here.
Striker.
Yeah?
First of all, you're choking me.
Sorry.
And secondly, what did Rion have in that cage?
I'd say you look like a night terror, but it was so small.
Maybe it was a baby?
Or it was starving. Poor thing.
What exactly does it eat?
Fear and meat, in that particular order.
Yeesh.
Aww, did all those positive feelings from the scary, bubbly dragon make you sick? No biting. Who'd ever want to buy you?
I can think of someone.
No way! That's the entire reason we don't sell to abyss dragons.
Speaking of which, you don't really want that badge, do you?
Clever, Droppy. We sure don't. We just need Striker to distract the guards with whatever stunt she's going to pull to get one while you unlock the vault.
We're going to rob the place? I didn't think we were that desperate.
Well, we are.
Can I come out now?
Good night.